Barometro Collection is a family of lamps made of copper and rosso levanto, a beautiful Italian marble composed of different colors, from red to white to dark green. Since I was back in Italy in June 2010, after 2 years in New York, where I work as an interior designer, I decided to change the direction of my production from fine arts and sculptures to design products, and that's how I start the Barometro Lamps, my first design collection. Marble means imagination, patience means stubbornness. Above all, marble means courage. To reign over it, to modify it, to soften it, to deflate it, even to kill it, it means to engage an inner match with myself and with all my creative gestures, because when you start to carve, you have to be very secure, you have to be straight. And you cannot make a mistake, because it's not easy to go back. I like to think that Barometro are actually sculptures that pretend to be lamps. I usually do not design before making a piece. I do not make preparatory drawings or maquettes, but I work directly with the stone or just draw on it. And Barometro makes no exception to this. I just follow the natural character of the marble and enrich it with cuts and forms that contain the accidental sum of its veins, defects, and hidden beauty. Each lamp is like a diamond that I shape and polish layer by layer. So each barometer is a unique piece made entirely by hand. They have been produced half in Carrara and half in Pistoia, my native town. The marble traveled from the quarries in Levanto, Liguria, cut and sanded carefully in my studio in Carrara, while copper lamina are curved and folded a few steps from my home. Metals, especially the copper, that is so ductile and delicate material that change also according to the atmosphere pressure, are confronting themselves with the stunning fixity of the stone. All in all, I think Barometro is a blend among caducity, temporariness, and durability.
State prizes rising out of the bomb holes. Skeleton boys hyped up in purple. Smoke rings blow from across the disco. Banknotes burn like broken equipment. Looking for shelter, readjust your position. Thought control, those written confessions. Two dimensions, dumb your head down. Gun don't look now, company missiles. Power is raunchy, rent a cops are watching. Make your dreams out of paper mache. Cliche wasted, hate taste tested.
Hell yes.
Not moving this way, I'm doing this thing.
Please enjoy.
Hell yes.
Now turning it on, I'm working my legs.
Hell yes.
Now I'm calling you out, I'm switching my plates.
Please enjoy.
Hell yes.
Now I'm cleaning the floor, my beat is correct.
Stretch to the limit, attention span, snap back the track. Collapse into laugh tracks, noise response, applause and hand claps. Floodgates open to the sound of the rainbow. Breaking points on the verge of pointless. Fools anointed to the followers.
For the copper lampshades, I decide the form and sides in a endless game of golden section with a marble base. in the end, it's all about problem solving.
Get your damn hands up. Hell yes.
Not moving this way, I'm doing this thing.
Please enjoy.
Hell yes.
Now turning it on, I'm working my legs.
Hell yes.
Now I'm calling you out, I'm switching my plates.
Please enjoy.
Hell yes.
Now I'm cleaning the floor, my beat is correct.
Yes.
Yeah, that's it.
I started to make sculptures when I was 18. I didn't apply for a fine art academy or for a sculpture MA, but I searched for a long apprenticeship in the best artisanal marble workshop located in Preda Santa, Tuscany, Italy. The heart of marble quarry is an industry in the world, together with the other Tuscany city, Carrara. I spent around 10 years working behind the scene by making monumental works on behalf of famous international artists, drenched in the natural light of the day from sunrise to sunshine.